Well, the next chapter of season 2 has been released. Crazy 8 have Crazy 8 Circle of 8 really is introduced in the chapter. We got Living Pharaoh, Abomination, this guy from some Spec Ops or something, I forgot. No, it was a chapter 1 of season 1 with the duplicates. And then we have Viper, the Hood, and Living Monolith. So these guys were from Spec Ops 6, and now they're back, finally. I thought they wouldn't put them in the game, but now they're not actual bosses, instead of epic bosses. I think that was a I joined around that time, so I never really fought them. I'm actually interested in playing them. I do have Scarlet Witch, so I can play this mission. I don't have to unlock it, so that's great for me. Hey. This chapter also introduces the uncanny Cyclops people have been wanting. If you know, this is the Cyclops from the 90s anime series, or comics if you remember, from way back then. This is the Cyclops I remembered as a kid growing up, so I'm glad that this costume's out. He has two different abilities now, along with his natural leader. Cyclops now has allies and his eyes. All his abilities work towards his team, so since he's a leader of X-Men, Cyclops and his allies have a chance to gain extra turn after attacking. Awesome. Attacks that would reduce an ally's health to 0 will have a 20% chance to reduce the ally to 1. This is not Phoenix's ability, this is, Wolverine and X-23's ability, when, you KO them and they come back to 0, like, little health. That's what it is. And you get both the Blaster and the Tactician, kind of like you got Scrapper and Bruiser of Iron Fist, so that's good. And then you have the Glaive Ceramic Knife, which is a golden version of the Mission 2 boss of this chapter. It's somewhat high damage. I don't know, it's based off level 10 there. Smart weapon. All the weapons in this chapter have smart weapons, which work in a certain way. Hopefully there won't be too broken weapons this chapter, like the first chapter, and they had to nerf a lot of weapons, which annoyed me and people that farmed them. And of course, gold and silver and command points still apply to the other bonus battles. And we also have a look into chapter 3. Punisher will be needed for the special mission. This is actually surprising, and I expect the PvP hero to be needed for a premium mission. That is great. Also, this chapter will introduce the classic Daredevil costume. So that is another thing to look out for. But this probably won't be out until Christmas, around that time, since it took 2 months for that one. So either December, we'll probably get this in December, because next month is the Spec Ops based off the Thor movie that's coming out, where Loki will be a lockbox hero. And I forgot the guy's name, the Watcher guy, he's going to be the unlockable hero. So yeah, that's the next Spec Ops. Of course, this update added new things. The max level has been increased to 13 now, which unlocks the new ISO-8s, the empowered ISO-8s. Which, let's take a look at them. They cost command points and gold, so the standard ones, they cost command points, so if you don't have all the heroes, this is kind of bad for you, if you want, but they're not level based, so you don't have to level up like these ISO-8s and then have to equip them. So this is good if you just want to get one, add a little boost to season PvP, it's great. Of course, the one I want is 80 command points immune to stun. Damn. And then you have the one that costs gold, which add class abilities to certain ones. Generalist, which one to buff, tactician, buff actions that are not quick actions, maybe a quick action once a turn. This is great because a lot of tacticians have buffs that are not quick actions, like Red Hulk and Black Knight. So this is great. And take reduced damage. All attacks have a small chance to remove beneficial status effects. Scrappers have 2. Unarmed attacks will not consume combo setup. Oh, they all have 2. Oh, infantry has 2. Counter-attacks apply poison. I guess that's okay, but not a lot of poison-based heroes. And then this one's also nice. Single target attacks have a chance to do splash damage. Oh, people love blasters, especially this season. There's barely any tacticians, I've noticed. And a big chance to gain extra turn while protecting. Oh, that's good. Oh, it is more. Okay, attacks again. What? These are good. Wow. Of course, there's character restricted ones, but that has to do with heroic battles, which heroic battles now have. They don't really have weapons, I think. They removed the weapons. It's not in one photo, but they have character-based empowered ISO 8s. So, for this chapter, this heroic battle, for this is Doctor Strange. Most people should have him by now. Doctor Strange versus Dormammu. This one is Daredevil versus Bullseye. I don't have Daredevil. Gonna need him anyway for the next chapter, so yeah, I gotta get Daredevil. And this one is Iron Man, Captain America, and Thor versus their duplicate lookalikes like you faced before, those green-looking ones. So that's our first triple hero heroic battle. And then we have Wolverine versus Deadpool and Bob, Agent of Hydra. Interesting. Wolverine versus Deadpool. And then we have Spider-Man versus Green Goblin. Damn, I need to get Spider-Man now. And then there's Scarlet Witch and Quicksilver versus the MCU Sentinels. So the heroic battles for the season, not so bad. At least I only need to get Daredevil, Captain America, and Spider-Man. So that's three heroes I need to get. Most of which I should have by now. I'm near the end of getting all the heroes. About 1,300 command points, excluding there are six Spec Ops heroes that I don't have. Let's take a look at the weapons. You got stun, but the damage is not shown. And they all have the smart weapon ability on all of them. The original ceramic knife. Some gauntlet. Gauntlet damage increases every time another smart weapon is used. Good in an offensive build. Not impressed with the damage though. Does actually damage to count to counter classes. That's gonna hurt infiltrators, all enemies. That's good, I guess. Somewhat good. And this one, that's some good damage. 4 hits, dampened. 10 rounds, damage is reduced. I wonder if that's stackable. I don't think it's stackable, but that's great. 10 rounds, damage is reduced by how much? I don't know. And then there's 2 multi-shot SMG. The damage is not shown yet. And extends support firing for multiple ammunition, which requires quick action, deals no damage when ammunition is depleted. And of course, Sugar Man's an epic boss battle. So Sugar Man makes his appearance again as a boss battle. And Red Skull is epic boss battle of Mission 4. So let's see, level 13. Empowered ISO 8, 6 more missions, numeric battles, incursions are each one, 2 in this one. What else am I missing? There's something. I think that's all for this chapter. The new stuff. I'm almost done with this. I farmed this. It was easy to farm in the Gambit mission. So pretty much you just do the first battle in Gambit mission, do the rogue battle, click the middle one or the left reward in the reward section, and you can get this easily. I've only gotten 3, 2 more to go. I should get them before the season's over, and of course shards will come as you complete wins. Oh yeah. Of course, with this PvP season halfway through, and you know, with the Tillian set, Rescue and Magneto and Omega Sentinel can't really beat you. I use a Blaster Agent, and I can pretty much kick Rescue and Magneto's ass so easily, because their damage gets reduced to nothing, and he can't get off balance by Rescue. So I'm not even worried about Rescue anymore with the Tillian set, the two weapons and the quick action weapon. Of course, there have been some changes to the game. Incapacitation now has a chance to stun at the end of character's turn instead of the beginning. Beneficial morale effects and Intimidate will place each other when applied. So I guess getting hit by Intimidate while having a buff will reduce stats. And then you apply it will increase as you debuff them? Something like that. Of course, we have three nerfs actually. They readjusted some weapons, but it's not really that important. Those who use a Solar Storm, that now will trigger counterattacks. Oh, I hate when it's something they say subtle does not trigger anything, but it does. Really weird. Players will no longer survive an attack that would KO them if they are party with Phoenix, and Phoenix is KO'd without activating Death and Rebirth. Wow, just hitting, just more burn, more fire, and more assault in the wound towards Phoenix. Wow. I just got her, and now I can't really use her in PvP, because she gets killed very easily. Let's see, Cyclops gets back in the fight with no longer proc while stunned. That has happened. Air attacks on teammates will have a 50% chance of procking a team get back in the fight. Yeah, that's alright. I hate it when they kept procking every single time everyone hits your teammate. Combat expertise on evasive maneuvers has been replaced with combat awareness, like the Nitroscope. It hasn't changed anything, it just changed the name. And Mega Optic Blast is now a 60% chance of applying incapacitation, so it's not guaranteed. And now the rogue nerf, well, not nerf, but correction. Southern Comfort will now correctly trigger only when Rogue is attacked. Before this season, past week, is just if you attack anyone, it triggered every single time. That was annoying. And then it says Southern Comfort will no longer proc a stun when used as a counter. That is, I don't think that's right. I don't know, I did get stunned earlier. Also, one last thing, but empowered ISO 8s for heroic battles, because several heroes are featured in heroic battles do not have the restricted ISO 8 earned in their heroic battles, which is Nightcrawler, Iron Man, Wolverine, and for now Wolverine Chapter 2 heroic battle features the same ISO 8 as Chapter 1. We hope to fix this when released. Moon Knight. So Moon Knight is coming us soon, probably before the Thor Spec Ops. Maybe. Well, we'll find out. Well, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoy this chapter. I'll be uploading more fights, the boss fights of each of them, and heroic battles, the ones that I can do, and maybe the epic boss battles if I can do them later on in the week or so. So yeah, thanks for watching and enjoy the season.